I don't think that it's fight for democracy because I don't think that they, for many years, they know what the democracy is. And of course, there is a fear that instead of the more steady regimes like it was in Egypt under Mubarak or in Syria under Assad, it's not democracy, it's tyranny. But that it's a very stable regimes that they were not enabled to some extremist groups to rise the head. I don't know what will come instead of them. It can be worse, it can be better, but what's clear that the unshaken situation is not very good, not for those countries, not for the neighbors, such as in Israel, not for the whole world. And I think that the learning for democracy have to come from the electoral circles of the population, and not by the coup, because by the coup there is a military situation, there is an extremists, the Islamic extremists, and the people who just want to make some happy things, anarchy. So we have to wait maybe several months in order to see what will happen. We have the case study in Egypt. There is an election in a couple of months.
In September.
Yes, and we will know what happens there. For us, the situation in Egypt is very important because we have the peace agreement with Egypt, and we believe that no matter who will come in this election, this agreement will be kept. The same situation in Syria. We don't have the peace agreement, but we have the cold peace or not hot war. And there is Hezbollah on our north border in Lebanon. And if something will catch the place of Assad in Syria, like the Muslim's brother or something like this, it will be very dangerous for Israel. Iran is the real evil for the whole population of the earth. This is a country that is controlled under the fanatical Islamist that is motivated by hatred. And the real danger that the person like him will have the nuclear weapon is the real dangers for the whole world. Don't make the comparison between Israel and Hamas. Israel is a state, a democratic state, and Hamas is a terroristic group that made the coup in the Palestinian Authority, killed and ran away many people of the legal Palestinian government, the people of Abu Mazen, and controlled the north of the sector Gaza, the other street. And from the moment they controlled this Gaza Strip, then they permanently bombed our south borders, our cities, without any provocation of Israel. In contrary, we gave them, not asked something to in return, gave them this Gaza Strip in order to normal their lives. And they used it against us for 8 years, and now they started another circle of violence. Hamas has to understand that there is a price for every start of violence. We never recognize in Hamas because it's, as I said, it's a terroristic group. It, when you kill innocent children and women and men in the very peaceful cities, it's called terrorism. It's not called, struggle for the independence or so. But Israel wants peace. He doesn't want to initiate any war, even against Hamas, this terroristic build house. But if there will be another provocations and another bombing our cities, and another trying to kill our people, like the ugly killing of the whole family with the babies and so on. Of course, Hamas will pay a very, very painful price, and eventually will end its days. I think that the first thing that we have to do is to put a price for every rocket bombing or for every attack against our peaceful population. And when we will put this price, and when the Hamas will believe that this price will be irreversible, I think that they will think twice before bombing us and sending terrorists to make the killing attacks against the population. I start from this point that everyone, every single person in Israel wants peace. I raised 3 children in Israel, and I want them to be to grow up with peace. I don't want my son to go to army and to struggle against Arabs. This is our willing and anticipation. But to say to you that we are sure that it will happen in this generation, in the next generation, I'm pessimistic. I think that there has to be new leadership, strong leadership, a very wise leadership, a modern leadership in the Palestinian Authority, in order to say stop this bloodshed. Let's first of all build the trust about the emphasizing the mutual projects, like economical projects, like touristical projects. And by this trust, by raising this basic trust, we will go to the defining and solving the most important questions, like the border questions, like the refugees questions, and so on. But you can't jump several floors and to start the building the trust. It's like the building. You can't to build it from the roof. You have to build it from the ground. This leadership is not existing now in the Palestinian Authority. Abu Mazen is a very weak leader. He, instead of fighting against the real group that bothering him and turning Palestinian peoples to the something like refugees and hostages, he fights against us. And it's very pity. He has to say to Hamas, or you with me, or I'm against you, because you are the factor, the damaging factor in the Palestinian people, not Israel. He can't do it. So we have to wait until there will be election, free election in Palestinian Authority. Maybe it will be new leader with the wisdom that will complete the mission of the total peace. The history learns us that every move that is taken by one side, it's wrong, and it doesn't lead us to anything except the war and some actions, hostile actions. Take the example that we gave them the other district. It was by one side. We did it by one side as the act of goodwill. But first of all, history tells us that in the Middle East, every act of goodwill they feel that we have some weakness and not goodwill. And the second thing, that you have 2 partners for tango. Even if you do some goodwill, but by one hand, it doesn't end good. Instead of peace, we received the terroristical organization of Hamas. So I expect from the United States, from EU, from the United States, from the United Nations, I expect from them to turn over this initiative and to say to Palestinians, stop, try to do some, you know, some not direct moves but indirect moves. Keep the negotiations, direct negotiations with Israel. Be brave. Find the forces to start building trust, and don't make these provocations about you know, vote for us for the building of our state. The first question that you journalists have to ask the Palestinians: do you know how to manage state? You want state. You can't manage the authority, the Palestinian authority that was given to you, because you lost half of them to the terroristical organization. So how you want to manage state from the political point of view, from the social point of view, from the economical point of view? You so much depend on the funds of Europeans and from the aid of Israel to control your territory, to subsidize your people. How do you want to do it by yourself? Yes, we will keep building settlements, because this government, first of all, was asked to do something that never government before was asked to do. I just want to emphasize that this is the right-wing national government, and although we agreed to freeze the building on the territories for 10 months, and we expected from our so-called partners, from Palestinian Authority, to evaluate this gesture and to do the same move. Instead of this, we received the trial trying to delegitimize us in every political agenda, in every political forum. They continue to call their streets and buildings and so on by the numbers of the terrorists that were participated in killing peaceful population. So in those 10 months, they didn't do nothing towards Israel, towards returning to the negotiation table. After those 10 months, we raised hands and we said we did our best. We didn't find the partners. We didn't find any steps toward Israel as we did toward them. Why have why we will continue to freeze these settlements? There are people there. They need houses, they need the schools, they need the children gardens and so on. They need to keep lives. When you will be ready to sit with us in direct negotiations, we'll talk. It's our greatest partner, it's our greatest friend. I think that as we interested in continuing this ally that continues many years. I think that the United States also is interesting in continuance of this ally. I think that United States, after we made our promises to freeze the settlements for 10 years, for 10 months, and believe me, it wasn't very easy decision for us. As I said, we are right-wing and national government, and there was never before that we were required to do these things. It's the first time. I think that the United States now understand us more than a year ago, and our relationships now are more friendly and more based on trust and understanding what's really happened.